world. Today, I'll be sharing my experience of using ChatGPT. So I've been tinkering with it for quite some time now. I asked it a multitude of questions, and out of all the responses that I received, I have selected a few interesting ones for this particular video. I'll also let you know if I found a particular response satisfactory or not, based on the accuracy and usefulness. Hopefully, this will give you a glimpse into the amazing possibilities as well as some major limitations related to this AI-based system. So, let's see how well ChatGPT performed in answering my queries. The moment you sign up by providing your email address and phone number, you'll see this dialog box, which provides some information that you may want to keep in mind. It says that our feedback will be considered to make the system better, and occasionally the system is capable of generating incorrect or misleading information. Let's see what's next. Your conversations will be reviewed by AI trainers to improve the system. So be mindful about what you share. Don't share sensitive information. We can also provide feedback by liking or disliking a particular response. And additionally, you can also provide further reasons for disliking a particular response. So let's begin with our first question. So my first question is, what is ChatGPT? And I also want some technical details. So as you can see, it is typing out one word at a time. So it's almost like you're chatting with another human being. At the bottom of the screen, you can see stop generating the response button. So you can stop generating the response midway as well. So that is our response. Here I can see that some basic information about ChatGPT is provided and technical details are also included in bullet points. It says that ChatGPT is based on transformer architecture. So this is the software architecture which is responsible for the current wave of generative AI-based apps. So I think it's a decent response. And here what I like the most is that the response isn't too long or too short. And it has also like covered basic level technical details. The amount of information which is presented isn't overwhelming. So overall, I'm happy with this answer. Moving on, I want to know if ChatGPT can provide me some information related to ENIAC. Now, ENIAC is supposed to be the first general purpose electronic digital computer. So that's our final response. Here, as you can see, it has provided the full form of ENIAC along with the names of the engineers who were responsible for its development. It has also included some details related to its applications and information about the amount of space it occupied. So this is definitely getting interesting. Now let's check if it has any idea about the women programmers who were responsible for programming ENIAC. By the way, I've also made a video on this topic. So if you're interested in watching the same, then you can find the link in the description. So again, it provided exact number of women programmers who were responsible for programming it. That is 6 and named 3 of them. Pretty impressive. Now let's check if it has any idea about the number of vacuum tubes that were used in this computer. So here I'm looking for a particular number. It says 18,000, which seems correct. Along with this, it has also provided some additional details, which is nice. Now, I remember debugging ENIAC wasn't an easy task. So let's see what it has to say about the debugging process. These are the exact details that I was looking for. So far, so good. What I like the most over here is that I didn't have to specify every time that I'm asking questions related to ENIAC. It understood that these are follow-up questions. So I felt like I was having a normal conversation with another human being about a certain topic. So overall, I'm pretty happy with the responses provided in this conversation. Now, ChatGPT has data until 2021 only. So I wanted to check what type of response will it provide for something that, say, occurred in 2022. so I asked it about the Save Soil movement. This movement was launched to create awareness about soil degradation and to bring policies to safeguard soil health by increasing its organic content. If you want to know more about this movement, then you can find details in the description. So after looking at the response provided by ChatGPT, for a second, I thought that it has access to data beyond 2021 as well. I mean, the description provided is absolutely relevant. But on drilling further, I realized that it was simply trying to guess the response based on the input provided. So a quick Google search would have provided the relevant link right at the top of the first search page. Here, the response seemed right, but it was pure guesswork. Anyway, sometime back, I read this article titled Lithography and the Future of Moore's Law. So let's check if ChatGPT can provide me a summary of the same. This was definitely published way before 2021. Again, here it is trying to guess the answer based on the words provided. But what is concerning is that the tone is extremely confident. On drilling further, I realized that it has never accessed this article. So I think this is the major problem of AI language models. They have no knowledge about a topic, yet they try to provide responses by predicting the next word. So if you have no idea about a particular topic, then you wouldn't even realize that the response provided by it is false or inaccurate. So again, in this case, I would have been satisfied with the conversation if it would have mentioned right at the beginning that it has no idea about this paper, it has never accessed it, yet it is trying to guess the summary based on the title provided. Let's ask it something very basic, like who's the richest person in the world? Again, very confidently, it is declaring that as of 2023, now, you don't even have information or data about 2023. Let's move on to something else. Now, you must be aware about Bard, which is based on Lambda. So Bard is supposed to be Google's conversational AI chatbot. So I asked ChatGPT what is Lambda, and it provided some basic information, which seems all right. Then I asked it to compare itself with Lambda, and I didn't even read the entire response. Because look at this first point of differentiation. Here, it says that ChatGPT is based on Transformer XL or extra long architecture and Lambda is based on Transformer architecture. I went back to an old thread or chat and I asked the same question, like which architecture ChatGPT uses. And here, it clearly stated that it is based on Transformer and not Transformer XL, which is the variant of Transformer architecture. Again, in the new chat, when I asked the same thing, it emphasized that it is based on Transformer XL, which is a variant of Transformer architecture. So it simply switches the answers randomly based on the previous input. And this is not the first instance. Many a times it has provided me different answers for the exact same question. ChatGPT can come up with a lot of stuff which won't even make sense. Like once it came up with the name of a book that doesn't even exist. The thing is that the responses are very compelling or convincing. The tone is extremely confident and the language is on point. This makes it very difficult to decipher whether the information provided by it is correct or not. Thus, one should avoid using ChatGPT to learn a topic from scratch. Or, in other words, you should use this tool only if you have sufficient amount of information about a given topic. Else, you'll have to verify every response before using it somewhere. Chances of you doing your task all by yourself are high because this process of double-checking everything can be very time-consuming as well as tiring. The second problem is that it is excessively verbose. One may not have time to read long descriptions for each and every query, particularly when you're looking for specific information only, like in case of closed-ended questions. Fortunately, there is a way to mitigate this. You can simply ask it to keep the responses short. Also, you should be careful about not sharing sensitive information, as most likely our inputs will be used to train ChatGPT, which means they can be regurgitated to people using it in future. So be mindful. Additionally, a normal search provides you links. You can click on any one and you can decide if the source is reliable or not. You can check the information and use it or discard it. But in this case, you have no idea about the source. And many a times, as I mentioned previously, it keeps on changing the responses for the same query. So it is very unpredictable. There are obviously many advantages as well. It definitely helps you in writing better code. So many developers are finding it very helpful. It can also help you in writing better emails, articles, essays, and even poems and jokes. It can also suggest Excel formulas. It can help you in creating better presentation decks. And there are many tutorials available online about how you can use it to become more productive. In short, potential uses are many, but human expertise is certainly required due to the limitations that were mentioned before. If you are still confused about when to rely on ChatGPT, then read this tweet by Sam Altman, the co-founder of OpenAI. Let's see what ChatGPT has to say about its own potential uses. Finally, there is just one more thing that I'd like to add. Some people are comparing ChatGPT with a calculator, and some believe that it can take away our jobs. So right now, the technology is definitely at its nascent stage. So it isn't a substitute for human expertise. But once it starts getting better and better, then who knows, after a decade or so, it'll be able to replace us as well. But then again, replacement of human workforce requires acceptance of technology on many levels. So it may still take time, but who knows? Right now, it certainly isn't a substitute for human expertise and judgment, but you can use this tool to become more efficient as well as productive. Before I end this video, listen to this poem composed by ChatGPT about ChatGPT. ChatGPT, a language model true, trained by OpenAI, its knowledge anew. A tool of power, it speaks with grace, answers with speed, and saves time and space. It knows the facts and stories untold, can help with questions, young and old. With language at its fingertips, it writes in prose or poems with lips. So let it be your virtual friend, a guiding hand until the very end. ChatGPT is here to lend a hand to help you in this digital land. I wish I could write such poems. Like and share this video. Subscribe to the channel. Let me know about your experience of using ChatGPT in the comments section. With that said, I'll see you in the next one. Bye, world.